From the book Structure Computer Organization from Andrew S. Tannenbaum, we're going to look at the 1-bit ALU. It looks like this one, an image here. And I have created the same image in this logic gate simulator here. Okay, so what can we do with this 1-bit ALU? Well, this is the function table. So if we set function 0 to 1 and 1 to 1, you have an add function here. So let's just try that out first here. Okay, so I set F0 to 1 and 1 to 1. Okay, and inverse should be to nothing, and I have to enable the input from A and B. Okay, that should just be a norm always. Now, is it true that if I say add A and B, so if A is 0 and B is 0, the output is 0 and the carry out is of course also 0. Okay, so if I say A1 here and 0 B, then I should have some output here. Well, you see, this is 1, so 1 plus 0 gives 1. And if I say B also, and I should have carry out here and 0 there. It's true. Okay, and this, if I close this A, you have one here and no carry out. No. And if I don't say carry in here, I should be output and a carry out here. So we can see it's perfect. Now if we change one here, we just have one carry out. And here, zero and then one out. So it's working perfectly like an add. Okay, so one, the function one and one is working as an add. So 1 and 0, if I take 0 here, it says not B. Okay, so if I say 0 here, you get an output here. And if I put a 1 here, you should get a 0 here. Let's try that. That's perfect. And this one doesn't do anything to the output. Okay, A doesn't come into the picture here. So that works also fine. So 0 and 1. So this one should be 0 and 1. I have an A or B. So if one of those are on, we have an output. Nice. Both, just also okay. And here we still have one, and then we close it. Works perfectly. And then if 0, 0, we have an AND function. Okay, so this should be AND. So one, if I put A, it's not enough. And if I said B, it's not enough. But I have to have both. And now we have an output. Perfect. And then we have one more function here to look at. And if I set function 1 and 1 here and invert to 1, and I get this strange one. This, and I can use this to see whether this input is the same. So we can see A is 0 and B is 0, and I have an output. So they are the same. So if I just say this one, now they're not the same, but now they're the same again. You see? And I have. So I can now use this in a condition statement to check whether A and B is the same. So this is how it's working.